Bonjour tout le monde. I want to start this morning by wishing everyone a happy Sikh Heritage Month. Every day, Sikh Canadians make our cities and our neighborhoods stronger. And right now, when people need help most, you're stepping up once again. In Regina, you're delivering supplies to your neighbors, while in Mississauga, you're donating to the Siva Food Bank. It just goes to show that we are all stronger together, supporting each other. You are doing your part, and so many others are doing the same. Aux gens qui sont aux premières lignes, merci. Aux agriculteurs, aux camionneurs, aux personnes qui livrent des cargaisons aériennes, aux infirmières et aux médecins, vous travaillez jour et nuit pour qu'on puisse manger et prendre nos médicaments. Vous protégez notre santé et la santé de nos familles. Votre gouvernement est là pour vous. Et tous, nous vous disons merci. Our government has introduced a three-point economic plan to protect jobs, help people laid off, and support businesses. If you're worried about your job, we're helping your employer keep you on the payroll with the Canada Emergency Wage Subsidy. Later today, Minister Morneau, Minister Ng, and Minister Baines will provide an update about this 75% wage subsidy. But what I can say now is that it's going to be available for businesses, big and small, that are not publicly funded and have seen a 30% or more decline in gross revenues. That includes everything from bars and restaurants to charities and nonprofits. Applications will soon open through the CRA. Like I said on Friday, this money is for workers. Employers will need to attest that they're doing everything they can to pay the remaining 25% of people's wages. These are unprecedented times and will require us to pull together as a country and trust each other as Canadians. So there will be stiff and severe penalties for trying to take advantage of this system and of your fellow Canadians. Notre subvention salariale de 75% est là pour les entreprises petites et grandes qui ne sont pas financées par des fonds publics et qui ont connu une baisse de 30% ou plus de leurs revenus. Ça comprend les restaurants et les bars, les organismes de bienfaisance et les organismes sans but lucratif. Vous pourrez bientôt faire vos demandes sur le site de l'Agence du revenu. Cet argent est là pour les travailleurs. Les employeurs qui utilisent cette subvention doivent faire tout ce qui est en leur pouvoir pour offrir les 25% restants du revenu des travailleurs. Et comme je l'ai dit, on est dans une situation sans précédent. On est appelé à travailler ensemble en tant que pays et à se faire confiance. Il y aura des amendes légales considérables pour ceux qui vont essayer de profiter du système et de leurs compatriotes. These are unprecedented times, so we're taking unprecedented action. And while we put this measure in place, we're continuing to move forward on the other two prongs of our economic plan. To help business owners worried about rent or other bills, we've brought in new loans. To help people who lose their paycheck, whether they're freelance or have been laid off, we created the Canada Emergency Response Benefit. And on that front, I have some good news to share. À partir du 6 avril, si vous n'avez pas déjà présenté une demande pour l'assurance emploi, vous allez pouvoir présenter une demande en ligne pour obtenir la prestation canadienne d'urgence. Je tiens à rappeler à tout le monde que si vous recevez la subvention salariale, vous ne pouvez pas récolter la prestation canadienne d'urgence. C'est l'un ou l'autre. Vous pouvez vous inscrire en visitant lecanada.ca. Lorsque vous faites votre demande, vous aurez le choix de recevoir votre prestation par la poste ou par dépôt direct. Après, tout ce qui va vous rester à faire, c'est de confirmer une fois par mois que vous êtes toujours sans emploi. Et encore une fois, si vous avez déjà présenté une demande d'assurance emploi, vous n'avez pas besoin de vous inscrire à partir du 6 avril. On va aussi mettre des mesures en place pour empêcher que les systèmes soient surchargés par les applications. Plus tard aujourd'hui, le ministre Duclos et la ministre Qualtrough auront plus de détails à partager à propos du processus et des critères d'admissibilité. Starting April 6th, you'll be able to apply for the Canada Emergency Response Benefit. A reminder, if you're getting the wage subsidy from your employer, you can't collect the CERB. It's one or the other. You can't get both of these benefits. For the CERB, you can register online at canada.ca. By selecting direct deposit, you should receive your payment within 3 to 5 days. If you can't apply online, don't worry. You can call the Revenue Agency for help over the phone. By mail, you'll get your check within 10 days. After applying, all you need to do is keep getting this benefit is check in every month to say that you're still out of work. And if you've already applied through EI, you're all set up. You don't need to do anything on April 6th. We're putting measures in place so we don't overload the system, but I can assure you that everyone will get their money. Later today, Minister Duclos and Minister Qualtro will have more details on this whole process, from eligibility to applying to getting your check. But the bottom line is this: we're getting you the help you need when you need it. We have a plan to protect jobs, to help those who've been laid off, and to support businesses that are having cash flow problems. And we're not done yet. We're going to keep working hard to make sure you're getting the support you need. This is the largest economic program in Canada's history. So I've asked the House Leader and the Deputy Minister to reach out to the other parties about bringing back Parliament. This must be a Team Canada effort. Governments of all orders across the country are stepping up to fulfill their responsibilities to Canadians. Canada hasn't seen this type of civic mobilization since the Second World War. These are the biggest economic measures in our lifetimes to defeat a threat to our health. These historic measures will support Canadians to stay home to defeat COVID-19. But the government alone cannot win this fight. We all have to answer the call of duty. This is service that most of us have never been called upon to do. We, each of us, have to live up to our end of the bargain. We must fulfill our collective responsibility to each other. Listening to public health rules is your duty. Staying home is your way to serve. So be smart about what you do, about the choices you make. That is how you will serve your country and how we will all serve each other. How well we do this right now determines where our country will be in 2 weeks or in 2 months. It's in our hands. It's in your hands. On a tous un rôle à jouer. On a une responsabilité collective. Là où on sera dans quelques semaines, dans quelques mois, ne dépend pas de moi, mais de vous. Je fais appel à votre conscience civique pour protéger les autres. Si vous ne respectez pas les directives, vous mettez les autres en danger. Nous avons tous l'obligation morale de rester à la maison. Nous avons tous l'obligation morale de prendre soin les uns des autres. C'est en travaillant ensemble qu'on va s'en sortir. C'est en restant fidèles à nos valeurs que nous resterons qui nous sommes en tant que Canadiens. Merci.